My bad. Got turned, flipped upside down. The lift is right there. Hey, what kind of orchestral role do you have on you, merchant dude? 25 grand. God.
Much obliged. Thanks very much. There you go.
Yeah, that's all me I buy for the time being. So there's 58 grand out there in orchestral roles to buy up. I really should take a look and see if there's a trophy for getting all those. I would assume so. Oh, fuck. For a second there, I didn't think Jill made it to the elevator. Wade! How are you, old buddy? We're doing pretty fucking bad, Clive. Or Lord Rosfield? There's Wade.
Squire, I need you to get those who can still walk up the lift to Martha's. But what about... I didn't ask, Oscar.
So, Wade...
Lord Rosfield, if you aren't a sight for sore eyes.
Martha seemed to think you might need some help. And by the looks of it.
We thought we could sneak by them. But we didn't know there would be so many. How could we have?
So the monsters have gotten stronger and rampaging more. Oh, fucking adamantoids. Okay.
We need to get the injured to safety.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
We can certainly try.
It's been a hot moment since I've perfect blocked Adamant Toys. Oh, and we get Wade joining us as well. Sweet. Oh, I don't have my just gonna tornado your asses to start this off then. Well, that was great. The crab died before it could do anything. Adamantoy's just ripping ass behind me here. Alright, tried to block that while I didn't have my Titan on. Hey. Your attacks are too damn slow, Turtle Boy. Oh, thought he was gonna get one whack off there. Think I'm gonna let you whack off in my face? No. Not gonna let that happen. Table flip! Oh, more enemies are coming. I'm gonna finish off this fucking Adamantoids before I get to them. Or I was holding on to the Scarlet Flame just for such an occasion. Had a feeling there'd be more of them. They wouldn't just hit me with three goddamn crabs and a big-ass turtle. Yes. Keep coming at me slowly. Call you Mr. Slowly. Did I fucking parry his attack by going in with that dash? No way. Okay, well, went to go for the Titan block. Apparently hit it a bit too slow or was still mashing attack on that. Oh shit, didn't expect him to die from that. That worked out quite well with the Flames of Rebirth. Killed every ad that showed up and... Fucking let me just keep beating the shit out of that Adamantoids. That can't be it. That still went easier than the other two fights.
Is anyone hurt?
I don't think so.
And yet again, you've pulled me from the flames. It's just a pity I keep walking into them.
You've never been one to shy away from danger, Sir Wade. Like any shield worthy of the name.
I see you're all in one piece.
Martha!
Is something wrong?
The lookout saw smoke coming from down East Pool way. Too thick to be a hearth.
A second horde.
Well, technically a third.
Always.
Jill and I will make for East Pool. You'll need to move the injured without us.
Don't you worry about them.
The moment my men are safe, I'll follow. Good luck.
I don't think, well, depending on how far Eastpool is, or 210 yards away, no, do I have to go up? Yeah, I have to go up. I don't know if my Flames of Rebirth will be ready for another fire off there. Well, Jill, we're doing good work? Wait, some Blood Axe mercenary talking mad shit over there? Who the fuck are they calling a mad dog? I'll kill you, tear your throat out. Then again, a lot of these mercenaries are having a bit of a bad time, so maybe I should be a bit more understanding and accepting. Maybe. Flames Rebirth should be damn close to ready. Oh, just a bunch of goblin. Goblin these nuts.
They're headed for the rest.
Let's see how this table flip does. That's one dragon down and one goblin remaining. Oh, some chocobos, huh? Oh no. Poor chocobos have been completely infected. Oh. Mind you, I've killed enough of these guys that I shouldn't really feel bad about it. Now, is there going to be another wave after these chocobos? Because this is easier than the last bit. Or was it supposed to be difficult because there's a shit ton of goblins? Whole screen went black. Scared the fuck out of me. I thought something horrible had happened. That was a rough transition.
Oh, Lord, geez, my Lord. Did I miss anything?
No, not really.
Only the first round, so wait. Shall we?
Actually, I think this is more like round 5. Sup, motherfuckers? Can you hold still, you bastard? Okay, well, I just took his bite immediately like that. Oh, fucked up the windup. Damn it. I hate screwing up that attack because it's so damn nice. I'm just going to go full out on this thing. It doesn't seem to be dying nearly as quickly as I was hoping. And broken again. Thank you. Get you with a table flip, get you with that. Then potentially should be able to finish you with a wind up. Yes. I like it when I can predict the damage amount to fucking kill him. Alright, that was a tiny bit more challenging. Just a skosh. Wouldn't say hard, but challenging.
Do you see any more?
No, we've killed everything.
I think that was the last of them.
Even the children.
But it won't be long before the next lot arrive.
Then we make for Martha's while we can.
So everyone's having a bit of a hard time of a go at it right now. At least they don't have to fight some fucking S-class dragon. Dragon is nuts
what
in their face.
Out there?
The same as Sir Wade. Of Akashic.
Well, wherever they came from, they're gone now. Our lookouts say the lowlands are clear. Hopefully we'll have enough time to lick our wounds.
How many of your men were injured?
God, I wish my name was Wounds.
Sight less than if you hadn't turned up. Thank you.
It was a hard-fought victory.
Was it?
But as long as the skies remain dark, I fear the Akashic's numbers are only going to rise.
Well,
it's not a matter of if the Horde will be back.
Just need to kill more monsters, then they
and
won't become a Kashyyyk, right?
We'll need to be ready. The inn here affords a good view of the land, and is easily defendable. I'd like to make this one of our outposts.
Are you asking me permission? You should be asking Martha.
You
she'd have more men to guard the rest.
Well, when you put it like that, of course they can stay.
Why did you say it like more men? Oh, I always need more men in my inn. The flames of war. Guardian's scarf, displayed in Clive's chambers, a symbol of trust, loyalty, and undying friendship. For as long as the Firebird's flame burns in our hearts, the duchy cannot die. So Wade. Oh, okay, so I get trophies from that as well.
Someone I'd like you to meet. Oscar, over here.
Wait, the boy you're giving you shit before that talked back? He looks a little bit like Gav.
It is an honor to make your acquaintance, Lord Rossfield. I am Oscar. Oscar of House Murdoch.
Murdoch? I wasn't aware the Lord Commander had children.
Oh. Wait one second here. Rodney Murdoch was, the Lord Commander. He died fucking in the intro.
My father did. I am Sir Rodney's nephew.
Oh! Didn't know that Sir Rodney had a brother.
It's not for me to ask him. Yes, Sir Wade.
You want to come work for me, boy?
If it pleased you, my Lord Marquis, might you take me as your squire? I would learn the duties of a shield from the finest.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, Oscar.
I failed as a shield. No longer. Technically.
Nor was I
supposed to protect my brother and killed him, but I didn't kill him.
Hardly seems a fitting education for one aspiring to take his oaths.
My Aunt Hannah once told me that a man is not defined by his title, but what he does in its name. You have accomplished much since taking on the mantle of Cid, winning no little honor in so doing. And I would sooner serve under an honorable outlaw than an unworthy shield. Not that Sir Wade and the other guardians are. I mean to say that,
Keep digging, boy. Someone get this man a shovel.
I know what you mean. There is only so much the boy can learn from me, my lord.
Would that really be so bad?
Could use some more extra hands around the hideaway.
And I'm certain Sir Rodney would approve.
Come on, Clive, you big old softy.
Know that I'll show you as much leniency as your uncle showed me.
I will not have it any other way.
Which was none. No leniency at all.
Our friends seem to have things under control. For now, at least. Let's go and put Otto's mind at rest.
Sure. Travel back to Otto. Boom. Just like that. Get my rewards for my renown. That's over 1,050, I think.
Your benefactors are a generous lot.
Hugo's men are gone, and with them the fear in our hearts. Once more shall the markets echo with mithril and merriment, or mirth and merriment. And it is you who we have to thank. Delamil Spicer. A pall lifted. Sounds good. If only I could upgrade my shit a little bit further with all my ability points. Then again, using other icons' abilities and such like that and upgrading them probably would be beneficial, but I really like the loadout I have right now. No risk, no reward orchestra. Talisman of priming. Just want to see the crossed off ones on the board and Nectar's Adventures, okay. Did I ever tell you about the time I flew all the way to the bottom of the Zemeckis Basin?
What did you find down there?
A deep understanding, Kupo. From the outside, it seems so mysterious. Where does all the water go to, Kupo? What? Fucking. Those were the questions I flew to find the answers to, Kupo, but instead I found something about myself. I can't swim, Kupo. Really, you hold on that for 8 seconds, but the fifth, the paragraph, you immediately go away from? It's annoying as fuck. Oh, this is actually different. He had multiple things to say. But never fear, Kupo. I nectar the bull shall always be with you in spirit. If you need more practical assistance, Kupo, then turn the toggle. Did you see that the Cursebreakers give every billet a rank in riskiness? Yeah. Okay, well, whatever that first sentence was, I didn't read it because I didn't think it was new information. Nice, and is it Varog? Because, a lot of Japanese things, oh no, that it's a silent T that I'm thinking of. So, Svarog? Svarog? Good amount of money, but Jesus Christ, it just kicked the shit out of me so hard. Why did you have to hit me so hard?
What will it be today?
Just asking you about the skies. I guess I didn't do that earlier before.
It is not merely the men and women of Alcea who have been affected by the imbalance of the aether. These blackened skies have cast a pall over the creatures of the realm.
Then how could it not?
They are living beings, just as we are. Alas, their instinct drives them to flee from that which cannot be escaped, ushering them only to madness and death.
But are we any better?
We consider ourselves above such base instincts, and yet fear the bewilderment drive us, yet fear and bewilderment drive us to make war on our fellow man, to turn our ire to our own suffering upon those who suffer just as keenly as we do. If that is what it means to be human, Clive, I wonder if we are even worth saving at all.
I cannot claim.
Not to have been shocked to learn of Twinside's destruction. Indeed, I have long known that such a fate was all but guaranteed. A piece of parchment was all that ever stood between the Dominion and Chaos, and those who signed the treaty were only going to abide by it for as long as it suited them. Emperor Silvestri's invasion saw it torn to shreds at last, and as the pieces scattered to the winds, long festering enmities came to the fore once more.
Such are the wages
of greed and distrust. If those in power pay heed to their whispers, they are like to grow into a mighty storm, one which the walls of even the stoutest citadel might not withstand.
Ironic, then,
that it should be Prince Dion, the boldest, most trustworthy player in the ignoble game, who should deal the finishing blow.
How may I help you today?
Just checking out the state of the realm. The roiling storm sweeps over Valsthea, bringing terror and confusion in its wake, and so too Walud. King Barnabas, sailing his kingdom's flagship, the Enhayir, across the strait, seizing upon the chaos that the plague storm since the destruction of the Mother Crystals and the disintegration of its nation's leadership.
Here you are.
And that to his ally's aid. Clive returns to the highway, but has little time to rest and recover from his exploits in the Twinside after the skies of Valsthea darkened. Chaos has swept over much of the realm, and his allies need his aid. Clive and Joshua are finally reunited at Twinside Council Chamber, and their icons unite as one in the skies above, the single supremely powerful entity they became, Ifrit Risen. It is at last able to best Bahamut, the Mother Crystal cracking in the process.
Of course.
Is there anything? There's nothing written on the right-hand side like that, huh?
The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
Yes. Constantly changing. It's the ebb and flow.
How are you doing?
Just want to see if there's anything else out there for Alliance reports. Nope. All taken care of. And Chopping Crown, that's to take a... Oh, yeah, the reading table. Yeah. I read everything at the reading table, right? Or did I only read a few of them and then wander away? No, I think I read all of them. Might as well go check it out. Take a look at my new little red scarf trophy. Where am I going? Oh shit, I really just took the longest way around to get over there, didn't I?
We're all gonna die.
Oops. Hey.
You hear me?
every single one of us.
You know.
How do you suppose they'll manage that? You ever seen one of the blue bastards swim?
All right, you guys done with your little banter? With the two hunts that I did, I should have the materials to build that better piece of equipment. It was a scarf, wasn't it? Can't remember exactly. Let's talk to Blackthorn and ask him about that. Hey, dude? Can you make me that thing? It's not that one. Is it that, or... Oh, the souls of Ouroboros. Wait.
Bring me the materials, and I'll think about it.
Yeah. I don't have the materials for this yet. Or did I use them somewhere else earlier? Am I looking at that? No, that's definitely monster materials.
Anything else?
Huh, okay. Why show it to me so damn early if I can't, you know, take the quest necessary to get the materials to build that? Why do you taunt me so? This is finally filling up. Took a long fucking time for it to get to it. Jeez. Guardian scarf. With his tippet dyed red for the flames of the Firebird and the blood of his fallen Rosarian brothers, does Sir Wade pledge not only his loyalty, but the loyalty of the Guardians of the Flame. Nice. Oh boy. The flames burn bright. You have an uncanny talent of showing up where you're most needed, my lord. Without your steel, I feel the rest would be in the hands of the Akashic, and us but more of their nameless numbers. However, with the horde now both thinned and fractured, we Guardians can focus our efforts on putting down the smaller packs without the worry of being overwhelmed, while Martha's blood axes can return to defending the Tor. As for young Oscar, you will forgive my sudden request for taking him under your wing. He is a good man, attentive, polite, hard-working. So, as you can see, he already has learned everything he can from me. He would do well to continue his squiring under a more worthy shield, and the realm has none more worthy than you, Wade. Oh, how fares the rest? The Guardians are getting along with the Axis fine enough, working shore up that the rest's walls, when not cleared out what few threats remain, down to the reeds, though chances are we'd still be neck-deep in Akashic had you not given that horde your firm but gentle nudge. I know you've a realm to save and all, but if you're ever in need of a quick reviver, come see us and we'll tap you a cask. Martha? Went a little bit Scottish on that, or Irish. Word from Northreach. Clive, you have the town's thanks for helping rid us of all of the thralls, but we are neither of us so naive to think we have seen the end of their like. Good Philip has taken to seeing that we are prepared should the ghouls come once again calling, but I oft worry the rank of the captain has begun to weigh heavily upon his shoulders. Just as I imagine the same might be said for you of you and your burdens. But remember, should the weight ever become too much, you needn't stand alone. Our hearts and arms remain ever open, as do the Vale's doors. Isabel. Dramatis personae. Come on, Luber. What's with the different pseudonyms? Damn. The gods and the liege have put aside their differences for the time, allowing us all to sip our snake spit in relative leisure. For that, I would hazard we have your better half to thank. She put on quite a performance. As for yours, well, from one aspiring thespian to another, might I suggest working on your delivery and your projection and those stiff limbs of yours and your continence and, well, everything else. We wouldn't want to do the name Underhill a disservice now, would we? Jesus, Luber, fucking tell me how you really feel, man. Everything's wrong with you, and you probably should just give up. Have you ever thought of that? No? Oh, pity. All right, Otto. I've wandered about enough. I guess enough. I guess I should progress the plot. Just for a moment. Till I get distracted by a dozen different other things. Sure, maybe I've talked to Hippocrates as well, but...
Hello, from all our friends thanking you for your timely intervention. How is it you always manage to arrive at just the right moment?
Luck, I suppose.
Yeah, that's great luck.
Any word on the rest of the realm?
Let's see. Storm's still crying out for Mother Crystals. The nations are still in chaos. And the skies are still the color of a kick in the kidneys 2 days on. So...
Right.
Clive, we knew this was going to happen. Well, not the bleeding skies part, but you take my point. Now's not the time to second guess yourself.
But everyone is suffering.
Visit the infirmary.
Not just the bearers anymore.
Brother's awake.
Oh, Shane, I was wondering about that. All this fucking around and my brother is up in the infirmary. Come on now. Can't go shoot the shit. Reminisce about the good times.
So it was not Sylvester, but Olivier who served as Ultima's puppet. And when Dion learned of this, he sought to slay the fiend.
He went a little mad. Go figure.
Only for his father to take the spear that would have freed him. Enough to drive a man to madness.
Small wonder he hasn't stirred. I would be afraid to wake.
Had I but reached out to him sooner, warned him of the threat Ultima posed. But now...
It's a little far-fetched and hard to believe.
I broke.
Joshua, what do you know of Ultima?
Very little, I'm afraid. Despite my best efforts.
One time. 1 second. Lore. No new lore?
18 years ago, as I lay buried beneath the rubble of Phoenix Gate, 'twas not death who came for me, but another.
Was that when...
It was while in my rescuer's care, I first heard of Ultima. I've been chasing his shadow ever since.
Ultima
is driven by some deep, dark purpose, and for whatever reason, it would seem you are crucial to his designs.
I'm so good at harnessing iconic power.
An empire.
But why me? What possible use could I be to such a creature?
That is one of many answers that have eluded me. Yet, I am certain of this. It is not mere chance. You were chosen for a reason. All dominants carry within them the might of an icon. Nigh limitless power that is at once acutely limited. I wield fire, and only fire.
And I only ice. 8 wardens for 8 elements.
8 elements?
But you... Clive.
How is Titan an element?
You are different.
What element is Bahamut?
Your abilities begin with the flames of Ifrit. But they do not end there. The fact Ifrit can even exist goes against everything we thought we knew of dominance. Perhaps Ultima has been waiting for one such as you, whose potential is truly limitless.
I've encountered that thing several times now. If it or he, as you say, needs me, why hasn't he claimed me as he did the boy?
You're not quite well cooked. You ran away before. You locked him in a flame prison at some point, or at least Joshua did.
His mind not properly attuned to your body.
His mind?
Mind, awareness, spirit, call it what you wish. But I believe Ultima to be an embodiment of the concept. This is why I struggle. And fail to contain him here inside me.
Okay, so he is still in there.
Inside you.
Wait, you're telling me that Ultima's
every setting sun
technically right here.